where Pam bears all.
I've waited for you for all my life.
Today we are hiking Pinnacle Mountain again, only this Pinnacle Mountain is in New York, quite a distance from Arkansas.
Reserve site N26 at Riverview, and it was a site that backed right up to the Scroon River. It was awesome. Well, we're hiking again. It's kind of what we do when we travel like this, but this looks like a great trail. It's called Pinnacle Mountain. We're in Lake George, so we're going to get a nice overlook of Lake George in upstate New York and the New York Adirondacks. Looks like a great trail. So far, it's paved.
It's not paved.
Not paved. It's graded, so it's not, yeah, not paved.
Today we are hiking Pinnacle Mountain again, only this Pinnacle Mountain is in New York, quite a distance from Arkansas, and actually quite different because Arkansas was boulders and rocks, and there are a few, but the path is actually pretty well groomed and relatively easy so far. We'll see what comes ahead.
If you go back to season one, episode two, of course there's only one season so far, but if you go back to episode two in Amazing Arkansas, you'll see that Pinnacle Mountain, which was probably a bit more strenuous than this one so far. This one's mostly switchbacks and, like I said, kind of a groomed trail. It's Mika approved, apparently.
She likes this one, I think.
Approaching the clearing to Lake George. Just really excited because I've always wanted to see Lake George, and we're about to see it here. Saw it yesterday from the shoreline, but now we're about to see it from I don't know how many feet up. But you'll see this as we come to the end. Let's hope I can keep my footing. Oh wow. You guys don't mind being on camera, do you?
Yeah. She's a Labrador?
Oh, wow.
Labrador.
That looks fake. That looks absolutely fake, doesn't it? It looks fake. Oh, my gosh. That looks.
I grew up halfway between Amanda and Savannah. Oh, really? I didn't detect any southern accent. I'm from the south. That's why I was.
Heading back down Pinnacle Mountain after a beautiful Lake George.
And the lunch.
And the lunch. It'd be good if you walked backwards until you fell down, then it wouldn't be good.
Ferns and moss.
More ferns.
Look at this.
Ferns and moss.
Look at how pretty that is.
Do you see what I have to deal with on hikes?
If we just had some water running through it.
Oh, it'd be magical.
That was a movie, right? River running through.
It'd be magical. It'd be like fairy tale land here. Well, she got the sign-in book, and she's been there for about 10 minutes signing in. I'm not sure what she's writing, but I'm pretty much sure there's more in that sign-in book than has made it into the journal for the roadsmiths. I'll have to ask her what she wrote. What did you write?
I wrote the time we went in, the time we came out, our name, our zip code, the number of people, and then I said, of course, we were there 2 hours. So I told them that we enjoyed a picnic lunch.
Mm. Well, I told our viewers that you spend more time doing the sign-in than you have on our journal. So at least we know the journal is will be left. Maybe it was journal practicing is what I think it was. I was going to leave my pamphlet, but I didn't have one handy. So I made it to Bolton, New York, which is right by Lake George. Little country store here. Got to sample the clam chowder. Pam's got a traditional New York Macintosh apple. Have you had a Macintosh before?
Mm-hmm.
A little tart. They're
oh, this is what I love about.
Yeah. Definitely tart. But it's good. Well, you can see behind me Lake George, and poor Pam's at the top of this hill. And she'll come down here and take a look at this as well. But pets are not allowed down in this park. It's too bad. We've run across a few of those, and we certainly understand why, but it is... it is beautiful. Water's crystal clear, and as you can kind of see behind us, I'm not sure you can see in the water, but just how beautiful Lake George is. I always wanted to come here, and so glad that I did. And it's deep, and again, you can see how quickly it gets deep right here, and we'll get you more details about just how deep this lake is, but with mountains in the background like that, you know that it's extremely deep. Lake George, New York Adirondacks.
Thank you.
Classic. Shop, shops, and more shops. Everything shops. Gotta go check out the lake. It's hard to get to from the shops, so we're gonna try that. Try to get down and see the water.
I need a t-shirt. Where's that t-shirt?
I don't know. I gotta walk fast here. She spotted a t-shirt, so I have to distract
just
her.
Just up here.
What's that?
Just up here.
I know, I gotta distract you. There are certain times in your life that you'll always remember where you were when it happened. You'll never forget that. The JFK assassination is being one of those. I was only just about 3 when that happened, so I don't remember that. Obviously, 9/11 is another one of those. But the other one for me is the win of the 1980 U.S. Olympic hockey team, which happened in the building right behind me. And that was an awe-inspiring moment for the whole country and for people when we won in the semifinals and then went on to beat, I guess it was Finland, in the last game, but beating Russia in that semifinal game was just amazing. So this was the scene of that. Olympic event site for the 1932 and 1980 Olympics, the bobsled.
And there's the U.S. number one team, fist driving. There they go. Talk about speed. Taking another curve, 1 mile a minute. Here they come up the finishing line. Chalk up another victory for the USA.
We're not bobsledding today. I'm a little too tall for a bobsled, but we're going to go walk up and see how much we can see. Apparently we missed the training. They're doing some training here at the top where they actually have like the top 100 feet frozen so they can practice their starts, which is apparently everything when it comes to this.
Into zigzag, see how he goes. Oh, he's high there. Coming out of it.
Held it down very nicely in zag. He should have a super time.
That's what he needs on the left to take the lead. He's done it again.
Easier going down.
Finish over there, but I can't imagine why it's a finish. But if you kind of look here, this is where you got the platform where I think they would kind of line up and then get their sled through here, and then away they go. Crazy. That turn is literally almost 90 degrees. Probably hard to see in the video, but it's got to be close to 90 degrees. Amazing. To
another Olympic venue here. So Pam's going to describe what it is we have.
So behind us here, you'll see the 90 and the 120 meter high jumps. And right now we're watching because if you look closely, you can see that backhoe or whatever halfway up. I think I'd rather be on skis.
Yeah, doing some
than
work.
That guy.
We'll put in a link, or not a link, but we'll put in a description in the video who actually won both men and women's 120 and 90 meter.
Oh, you know what he's doing?
Ski jump. So,
he's taking loads of rock up.
Yeah,
and
up
he's
to the top.
The
yeah, yeah, that's crazy. Wouldn't catch me doing that, that's for sure. But, so we're here at Riverview Campground in Warrensburg, New York, which is just outside of Lake George, and it's really been a great campground. You can kind of see we're right along the river. That's why they call it Riverview. It's been really good. When we got here over the weekend, it was pretty crowded, but a couple empty spots. But if you look around now, the place really cleared out. We have almost this place to ourselves, at least on this row by the river, and I'll show you the other side of that as well. But it's been really, really good. Had a chance to go see Lake George and hike a couple days ago. We're going to do that again today. And we went to Lake Placid yesterday. You'll see some of that in the video. But you'll just see exactly how much space we have here. It's pretty amazing. Pretty good. We're here till tomorrow. And on to the Boston area. So really, really liking it here. It's been beautiful. It started out foggy this morning. And it cleared off, and we're gonna go do a big hike, and we'll show you more Lake George on a pretty day.
Ken and I are hiking in the Adirondacks. This is called
the Cat and Thomas
via something. I forgot, the Red Trail or something.
Pond or river.
Oh my goodness, but look at this. We're hiking along, and it's a really nice trail. And then we walk up to this. This is just like perfect. And this is how we hike. Okay. Okay, this is the hike. We're sitting at 2.3 miles of what felt like straight up.
Wow.
And we have been rewarded. With this.
Oh, goodness.
Wow. Ah, and just about a half of a mile or so back, we sat down and ate lunch because we weren't sure if we were on the right trail or not. And look what we could have had lunch to. Wow.
This is higher than, because Pinnacle is over there, I think. See it? I can see it.
Can you hold her?
Yeah. Since it was a much nicer day than 2 days before when we hiked the Pinnacle, we decided to go back and look at it again. There's actually two routes. We chose the easier route this time since we're going to do another hike. The easier route is about a mile. You don't go quite as high as the other. Then we decided to go to Cat Mountain, which is a pretty grueling 6 mile round trip hike to the top, which sits further back. And you can see just how much the weather had changed from by the time we went to Pinnacle and when we got to the top of Cat Mountain. So this is Lake George Village. It's quite a bit bigger than
Bolton Landing. Bolton Landing was really
a little more
really
quaint.
Cool,
yeah,
like
a little
that.
More quaint. This is a little more touristy, bigger, but it's pretty because you can see the houses across the lake over there. It is very pretty. We're waiting for our table to be available, and our legs are killing us from the hike today because it was pretty grueling. I wanted to call that hike Multiple Disappointment Trail, because every time you'd get around a corner and you thought you were at the plateau, it just leads you back into the woods, back into another hill. But the view is worth it, as you'll see on the drone footage. So, the beauty of Lake George.
Yeah,
right here. Just waiting for dinner. And enjoying a little bit of relaxing time after that strenuous hike today.
The problem is we had to come down to get to the water, and that means we have to go
back. Well, you'll see on the drone footage that we had just exactly how high we hiked up today.
Wow, look at those houses over there.
Yeah, it's very pretty. This is where Pam bears all.
I've waited for you for all my life.
I think most people think of New York City when they think of New York, but it's so much more than that. Upstate New York has so much to offer. I just love New York.
And always, if you like our videos, go ahead and give us a like, subscribe, and hit that bell to be made aware of new videos coming out.
Coming up next on The Roadsmiths.